I'm standing here in front of the Odysseus drug consumption room in Athens, Greece. The drug consumption room was created by the government in response to the growing HIV epidemic among injecting drug users. Unfortunately, the service has been cancelled this year because of police accusations that the service itself is illegal. Now there is a debate about the legality of the service.
OKANA is the largest non-governmental organization that provides services to drug users in Athens. We followed its outreach team on its daily route to talk to drug users and locals about the situation on the streets.
In every corner there is a coffee shop where there's dealing and using.
Εδώ κατά κύριο λόγο κάνουν χρήση ενοπλέδια, ηρωίνη. Έτσι εμείς ερχόμαστε, μιλάμε στα παιδιά, τους ενημερώνουμε κατά βάση πού μπορούν να πάνε. Δίνουμε ενέσιμο υλικό, καθαρές ήρυγες δηλαδή.
Πρέπει να βρισκόμαστε από το χώρο, γιατί εδώ θα βρούμε την ηρωίνη, εδώ θα βρούμε το φίλο που θα μπορέσει να βοηθήσει αν δεν έχουμε χρήματα και δεν θέλουμε να κλέψουμε, δεν θέλουμε να κάνουμε αδικήματα κτλ. Άσχημο πράγμα για έναν που έχει τα παιδιά του εδώ και θα πάει σχολείο. Δεν πάει σχολείο.
Μας πείτε γενικώς τι προβλήματα αντιμετωπίζετε με τους χρήστες εδώ γύρω. Ποια είναι η κατάσταση?
Η κατάσταση είναι πολύ άθλια.
Θα κοιτάτε από
εκεί. Είναι πολύ άθλια η κατάσταση. Όπως βλέπετε απέναντι είναι το σχολείο. Μικρά παιδιά από εδώ περπατάνε. Το πρωί δεν μπορείς να περπατάσεις από τις σύρεγγες. Είναι πολύ επικίνδυνο. Από το πρωί ως το βράδυ αυτή εδώ είναι. Να μην σας πω τι πράγματα εδώ. Χαίζουν, κοιμούνται τα πάντα. Έχει φτάσει τώρα η κατάσταση τελευταία, αφάνταστα έχει χειροτερέψει. Παλιά δεν ήταν έτσι.
Εκτός από ζευγάρια και μικρές παρές, έχετε και έτσι μαζικό κόσμο.
Μαζικά. Εδώ επειδή έχουν τα σκαλοπάτια, τα παίρνουν και έρχονται εδώ που είναι ήσυχοι, μικρός πεζόδρομος, σαν πεζόδρομος, και ξύνουν.
Όλη την ημέρα.
Από το πρωί στο βράδυ.
Μάλιστα. Οπότε είσαστε υπέρ του να μαζευτούν όλα αυτά τα άτομα σε ένα χώρο που να κάνουν...
Δεν είναι υπέρ, δεν είναι το θέμα. Λέμε ότι είναι άρρωστοι, καταλαβαίνω ότι είναι άρρωστοι. Άμα το κράτος δεν πρέπει να κάνει κάτι, δεν πρέπει να προστατεύει εμένα τα παιδιά. Τι παράδειγμα δίνουν στα παιδιά?
Σωστά.
Είναι άρρωστοι, να τα συγκεντρώσουν κάπου, να τα θεραπεύουν, να δουλεύουν εκεί μέσα, δεν ξέρω, κάτι να γίνει. Αυτή δεν είναι η κατάσταση.
Ακριβώς.
Η κοινωνία έχει πολύ τρομερό δίκιο, φοβερό δίκιο, γιατί έχει τα παιδιά τα οποία θα δουν το χρήστη είτε να κάνει εθνοπλεύειες είτε μυτιές και είναι κάτι πολύ αντιαισθητικό για ένα παιδί.
Ναι, αλλά την αστυνομία... ίδια στιγμή η κοινωνία χρωστάει στο χρήστη τη θεραπεία του.
Χρωστάει,
οπότε τι θα κάνει κι αυτός? Δηλαδή είναι αλυσίδα. Δεν του δίνει αυτό που χρειάζεται, ναι, και εκείνος αναγκαστικά τι να κάνει?
Ποια
άλλη διέξοδο έχει από το δρόμο? Να πάνε εκεί που χρειάζονται, να πάρουν αυτό που χρειάζονται και να μην ενοχλούνται και εκεί.
There are approximately 20,000 people who inject drugs in Greece, most of whom use heroin. After the economic crisis hit the country, high rates of poverty and unemployment among young people led to growing injecting drug use. Consequently, the new HIV infections among drug users almost doubled between 2011 and 2012. The government responded with scaling up harm reduction services.
The response of the state to the epidemic was prompt and apparently effective, because in 2012 the number of OST substitution treatment units were almost doubled and the harm reduction programs were also increased. needle and syringe distribution and injecting kits distribution were increased. Most of it was European money, European funds, but they were put into good use. And as a result, it seems that the 2013 numbers show that we have managed to contain the epidemic. It's not increasing anymore. We have managed to keep it in Athens. No other city has a problem, and in the population of injecting drug users.
Drug users' life in the streets are extremely harsh and brutal.
Yes.
We have to mention that until now, and until there is a drug reform, drug users are really experiencing a terrible situation of repression, police repression every time in the streets of Athens, and we cannot close our eyes in this.
Police, she take orders from somebody, she beat us too much. You, not just verbally, you know what I mean. They hit too much the people.
I remember I was arrested just for an identity. He had me in my cell. I was starting to get the chills, and he was coming to the bars and saying, "Hey, honey, what about a blowjob, and I will give you an hypnostadone." And they were laughing.
After successfully scaling up access to substitution treatment and sterile needles, the next aim of Manny Mariori, the former head of OCANA, was to open a supervised drug consumption room in Athens.
I'm a doctor. I'm a medical doctor. And to save a life is very important for me. To have every kind of facility that saves lives. And we were lucky enough to make an application for European Union funding, co-funding with our own funds. And we started in September 2013. It was not only a unit for supervise or save use. It was also a unit to sensitize drug addicts, to learn them how to use safer whatever they have, even if they are in their own house or on the streets, to give needles and syringes, to motivate them in a way, not from the first day but later on, when you have a relationship between the personnel and the addicts, to motivate them to enter in a treatment facility. So it was much more. And of course it was also a place where an addict could inject his own stuff, I really mean it, its own stuff, instead of doing this thing in public.
Τον Οδυσσέα, το ξέρεις, το shooting room, το μέρος που μπορούσες να πας να κάνεις ασφαλή χρήση. Στην 3η Σεπτεμβρίου, εκεί που είναι το κεντρικό κτίριο του ΟΚΑΝΑ, είχε ανοίξει ένα μέρος που πήγαιναν οι χρήστες, τους έδιναν καθαρές σύρικες,
ναι,
όλα
τα
υλικά.
Πάω εκεί.
Έχει και
χρήση, καθαρά, γιατρός. Γιατί κακά τα ψέματα, παιδιά πολλά που έχω δει εγώ εδώ, κάνουν εθνοφλέβειες από όπου βρουν. Ένα να τον βρήκα πήρε από κάτω και του λέω, αδερφέ μου, τι κάνει. Αλλά που ξέρεις ότι αυτό μπορεί να σε κάνει καλά τώρα, θα να σου δημιουργήσει μια, στο μέλλον ένα πρόβλημα που να πεθάνεις κιόλας. Θα έπρεπε να γίνει κάτι. Εγώ θα ήθελα, παρακαλώ πολύ εμάς, τους τοξικομανείς, τους χρήστες, να μας δώσουν κάποιο χώρο, να μην ενοχλούμε κανέναν, ναι. Mm-hmm. Κάποιο χώρο που να είμαστε εκεί, εμείς.
Mm-hmm. For some people, this consumption room was a place where they could stay at least for half an hour and much more, because the people here were taking care of them. Just to rest and avoid the the chasing of the police without any hastiness and fear, and perhaps harming their veins and their circulation, or the danger of an overdose.
What does the evidence say, for example, EMCDD say about drug consumption rooms? Are they effective? What good practices we have in Europe about them?
In Europe, in the last years, mainly in Europe, there is a shift to harm reduction. There is an opposition to zero tolerance. So consumption rooms are an effective harm reduction measure. The important task of the state and of the professionals who work in the field is to save users' life. This is the primary task. And then users, if they want to, they can go to treatment. Also, treatment should not be obligatory. It should be voluntary, as the treatment of any other human being. It is a choice.
Probably there are a lot of people in Athens and in Greece who think that drug users are responsible for their own fate, and they are not like people with cancer who just got the disease, but drug users, you know, have made a decision to use drugs. So why should we pay for this kind of services? So what would you respond to this?
They already pay for that. They already pay for the prisons. They already pay for the police and the political repression. They pay for the violation of human rights, which drug users really experience every little moment of their lives. So I think it's much better, if they're gonna pay, to pay for human attitude, to pay for a human hand to give to these people and help them perhaps go up instead of pushing them to the bottom.
The daily cost under OST treatment is around 7 to 8 euros. If the same person is in the prison environment, it's usual with drug addicts, The daily cost is almost 30 euros. And if the same person is on the streets, the daily cost is around 100 euros. 1 euro in treatment, you save more than 10 euros at national level.
Even though the number of slots in substitution program has doubled and users no longer have to wait 8 years to get into treatment, there is still a waiting list of 3 years for this type of life-saving treatment.
The users' lives are in danger because they are not all covered through substitution or any other kind of treatment. Half of the users are in treatment, we estimate. So for the rest of the users, we should have consumption rooms, we should have every harm reduction unit and intervention available. The consumption room Odysseas was established as part of the treatment. It was considered as the first phase, the pre-induction to treatment. All the users who were registered in the consumption room were in the waiting list of the substitution program. They had no way of entering substitution as yet, so they were offered this consumption room as a protection for their life and for their health whilst waiting for their turn to enter the treatment.
Effie, why the drug consumption room has been suspended by the government?
As soon as a very big channel had a show dedicated to the drug consumption room, the police intervened immediately and came to the employees under the order of the public prosecutor, accusing them of facilitating drug use. Odysseas is completely sealed. No one can even see or take pictures of the place. The staff is not allowed to give any information or talk to anyone. Otherwise, they will be in trouble.
The consumption room is not closed. It is suspended, which is something temporary. And we all hope that solutions will be found and that the project will open shortly.
I don't take the responsibility to close. I don't take the responsibility to open. I keep it frozen. I don't know what's this. If you have to save lives, either you do something to save lives, or if you don't want to save lives, you take also the possibility of the opposite. For me, it's unbelievable what's going on. If it's true, I don't believe it. If it's true that there is a legal problem, even though it's a pilot study, you have a pilot for 1 year, and according to the results, then you go and you put an amendment in any kind of law, and you have the legal basis. But you need a pilot first. But let's say that they want first the legal basis, and then to start the activity. Okay, June, July, August, September, October now. Why they don't put an amendment in any kind of law that they vote? If they really want to keep it.
Our only message is this man who's knocking at this door and is waiting for the drug consumption room to accept him might be your brother, your sister, your husband, or even yourself.